good afternoon to you, one and all. This is Little Daffodil coming to you today from something a little different, the Twitch Launcher. You're wondering why. Why are we coming to you from the Twitch Launcher? Because I just ended Horizons 3, and I wanted to do something specific for this next series on modded Minecraft. Specifically, I really wanted to focus in on Industrial Foregoing. I really enjoyed it in Horizons 3 early on. I kind of felt like it had a lot to offer. And I felt like I was coming to understand it. And so I really wanted to focus in on it. Okay. So I went looking after Horizons 3 was ended for a pack that would give me that as the core. There really isn't one. There really isn't. Now, I say that, but I will make the exception that if you're watching the One Man, One Mod series by Dadcraft, he did recently do a One Man, One Mod with Industrial Foregoing, which was ironic because I had already started Horizons 3 and he got onto this pack. And there were some things in there that he talked about that I found very, very helpful. Now, the way I watch quote-unquote videos for the most part is I tend to have them playing in my ear or in the background when I'm playing a game, unless I'm specifically looking for something, a specific tutorial or whatever. So I listened to Dadcraft's videos on Industrial Foregoing unless I was looking for specific information and I went to him or to a tutorial or whatever. But his series, One Man, One Mod, which I highly recommend that you look at. Right now he's doing Britannia. It's really cool. Actually, I love Britannia, so it's nice to see it being the one that he's doing right now. And his series inspired me to go ahead and kind of put together my own mod pack. Now, I'm not talking about a mod pack that's going to get posted for everybody to use because I don't know how to do that. I am not technical. I don't program. I don't do any of that stuff. There are things I cannot do, and maybe someday I'll learn them, but, you know, I'm still a noob. So I just decided to go to the launcher, the Twitch launcher, and put together the mods that I want. So that's what I did, okay? And I'm going to walk you through what I did and show you the mods that I picked. And I did this a little bit ago, several days ago, almost a week maybe, and have been testing the pack since. And I'm happy with it. I'm actually having to restrain myself from adding a few more things though, because every time I think about it, I'm like, oh, but I like this mod too and I want to use that mod. No. I want to focus on Industrial Foregoing. So today, I'm going to show you how I put the pack together. Okay, so the process is actually really simple. I mean, I did this, so let me tell you, it's simple. Start a custom profile, give it whatever name you want, and I called it my industrial pack. This is going to be a repeat because I've already created this profile. I'll get rid of it when we're done from this. The next thing you need to do is decide what version of the game you want to do this in. And I based it on the latest version of the mod that I want to know, Industrial Foregoing. So I found out by looking it up online that it's 12.2. Okay, so then it automatically gives me the right Forge version, which you can't run mods without, apparently. And then click OK. Now it's going to create that profile for me. So in my mods, I find it here. So now I view the profile. Okay. And right now I have no mods installed. Okay. I have no resource packs, no maps. I don't even really know what the maps thing are. And resource packs, I have a resource pack for vanilla, but I don't really use it in modded. Because that's playing with images. I like that. All right, so let's go get some mods. Now, when it came to figuring out what mods I wanted, I really had to think about, keep in mind what I was trying to accomplish, and then also keep in mind what, for me, makes playing better. So the first thing to do was, of course, to get industrial foregoing. So right there, you find the mod you want, you click install. It not only installs the mod, it installs the mods that you need to run the mod. So that was really good. Now, industrial foregoing was, of course, an obvious choice because I needed it. So now to go along with it, I have this long list. Actually, it's a pretty long list because I wanted things to help me with building. And I needed things to help me with industrial foregoing that I didn't realize until I started testing it. Now, one thing I wanted was definitely better builder's wands because I do want to actually build a base. And I find that helps. I don't know if I'm going to need it, but I decided to go with chest transporter as well because I think that if I'm going to use the simple storage that I learned to use in Horizon 3, and so I want to be able to pick up a full chest and move it if I decided to rearrange that system in any way. I definitely want chisel. Again, it's going to help with making the base, which is a good thing. And then we're going to get into some kind of environmental related ones. So fast leaf decay. Love that mod just because it makes the world cleaner quicker. This one, feed the beast utilities. If for no other reason, because it gives me a trash can that I can use. So when I get overloaded with cobblestone and stuff, I can just open up my inventory, pop open the trash can and toss stuff out. And also I think it's going to give me the ability to do chunk loading without a device. And I kind of like that. The next thing, and I'm kind of going in alphabetical order, inductive logistics. This gives me pipes and tanks. I was initially looking at using a mod that I knew, I know a little bit, extra utilities, but that started sending me off in different concepts that I didn't want to go in. It took me away from what I wanted to study. So this is something that DadCraft 73 used in his videos, which is how I found it, the inductive logistics, because I was looking at some other packs that I knew contained pipes, but they also contained so many other things that I didn't want. I was afraid I would get lost in those rather than just sticking to industrial foregoing. All right, inventory tweaks. It makes just managing, you know, it's how you can sort a chest and that kind of stuff. So it's a really useful thing. Plus, when you break a tool in your hand, it's automatically replaced. Those are just little things that make playing a little easier for me personally. And then we need iron chests, and I went with iron backpacks as well because I like those. I think those are really cool. Journey map. Because journey map rocks and it makes life easy. Then we have JEI and JER. Is that the right one? JEI and JER for, again, managing inventory and the resources and looking things up. That big menu on the right that I love. Okay, mouse tweaks. It just helps with inventory management in other ways as well, relative to the mouse buttons. Something I didn't even know I was using, really, until it wasn't there, and I went looking to find out how some things happened. So it was really, really cool. Now for the series of symbols. We have the simple storage network, which you saw in the last series. I think it's great. I do. It's easy early game storage, uncomplicated, gets the job done, makes things easier. Simple generators. This is by Valkyrie of Night, and I grabbed this because the one thing, the industrial foregoing, and I found this out when I started testing the pack, it doesn't have you have to have power to start, but you can't make generators until you've made plastic, and you can't play plastic without power. So I went with simple generators, which I'm going to use just to kickstart, and then I'm going to stop using. So I'm going to allow myself to make one basic generator from there. Simple harvest, which is makes crop collection easier. It's the right click and it collects the crop and plants a new one. Now, the next thing I was looking for, I didn't want to put tinkers in here. I didn't want anything like that, but I really wanted some kind of way to mine quickly. Sparks hammers. This is the way. And again, that learning about this came from the Dadcraft series, because before that, I didn't know about it. So that was great. And then there is the one probe, which gives us the top middle screen where it tells us what we're, the block that we're currently looking at and what it takes to break it and how long it can take to break it. The next thing, Torchmaster, because I just love me these torches because they help keep everything at bay. And then the last thing, and I'm not sure yet if I'm going to actually use it. I don't know. Ooh, wrong. Where did it go? I don't know if I'm going to use it. Where did it go? Oh, here it is. The Auto Crafter. This is something else that Industrial Foregoing doesn't have, is an Auto Crafter. So you have to assemble everything else, everything manually. So I grabbed this, I've tested it, it works. I'm still not sure how I'm gonna use it. I do wanna automate the production of plastic. I don't know, I'm not sure. I grabbed it because it does at least help me automate plastic, which is as far as I've gone in the testing pretty much, is to get to the most basic machines and making plastic and all of that. But and anyway, that is everything on my list. That is what I'm putting in there. So now let's go back and you can see they're all there. They are all there. And like, you didn't see me put in Tesla Core Library, but it's there because something else needs it. Okay. So not only did the mods I pick get installed, but the mods that the mods need also got installed. Now I went through and I checked, and I think it's all okay for me to use them and to use them in videos. One of the reasons that I am doing this video is to make sure that they all get a moment in the sun, especially these ones in the background, like fast leaf decay, because we all kind of know it's there, but do we know it's there? Do we talk about it much? No, probably not. Connected textures mod. It's needed by something in here, maybe chisel, I don't know. You know, I just want to make sure and give every one of these a second on film, so to speak, before I start the series, because I'm very grateful to the people who put these together, because without them, I wouldn't be able to have the fun that I'm about to have. So, you know, this is, Minecraft has been a lot of fun. I enjoy different aspects of it, and this is a new aspect. I actually went into the Twitch launcher and assembled a pack of mods that I want to try to create a world to have fun with. So now all I have to do is hit play. It's going to load the game, which it may be doing. Yeah, it's doing on it. Here we go. And hit play and start a world. That's it. That's it. That was not hard. Now, I'm assuming there may be times if I am attempting to assemble a pack where it turns out that the pack, some of the mods don't work well together. Everybody's out there making their mods the way they want. That's great. And maybe they don't all work well together, and that's okay. So if you decide to assemble a pack for yourself to play full of your favorite mods, remember, the more mods you add, the heavier it's going to get, the harder it's going to be for your computer, and the more likely you're going to have conflicts. So read the mod creator's information very carefully. So like, if you click on it, on the mod itself, you can read about it. Okay, you can read information. You can also go online and get more information. So make sure you read it, see if there are any known conflicts, that kind of thing. Make sure it's going to be usable for you. And make sure that you try to respect the desires of those who created these mods as far as their getting credit, the credit that they deserve for their work. And you know what? Have fun. Just have fun. So, that's it. 33 mods loaded, 33 mods installed. Industrial pack. That's what I'm calling it, just because I can. And like I said, this isn't something you're going to find in the Twitch launcher. This is something I assembled exactly as I just showed you I did. And it was fun. I enjoyed it. I am so grateful to all those people out there who are making mods for this game, because I am having a lot of fun with it. And the mods make it even more fun. I'm going to go play vanilla again at some point, but the mods are making it fun and I'm enjoying it. And I cannot wait to get to know Industrial 4 going even better than I do now. So I think that's it. You've made it through another video, folks. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time. Any time you choose to spend with me in the world of video is much appreciated. If you have any questions, comments, or mod recommendations for future series, let me know, because, you know, I'm feeling like trying out different ones. But for now, we'll stick with this. So look for Industrial Pack coming to a YouTube channel, near me. Hopefully near you. Sorry, that probably doesn't make any sense, but I'm tired. So I'm going to go get some sleep, folks, and I'll see you in the next video.